The enemy will always try to disturb, shake, confuse, doubt, question our relationship with God, God's guidance, and even God himself. I went through this and I still do. And I'm here today to tell you about 5 ways the enemy uses to disturb our relationship with God. So let's start. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I am so happy to have you here today. Welcome to all new subscribers and welcome back to all returning. I am Joelle, I'm a Christian life coach. I am here to help you with faith content, life advice, self-development, and truly what God put on my heart to coach you on. Throughout my faith and my walk with Jesus, I have learned that the enemy, Satan, has several strategies to destruct and to even take us back to the road that God has set us free from. 2 dreams I had, one I spoke about last week when I was chained and a dark spirit pushing me down, when 2 righteous hands came down from above and pulled me. And another dream I had about 3 weeks ago, when in the middle of a very chaotic dream, I hear a voice, it was the voice of God, I know him, telling me, pray for directions. I have thought about those dreams many, many times, and for me, the most profound picture in the dream was the hand of God delivering me and the voice of God instructing me. I have learned this truth in my walk with Jesus. He protects, guides, and provides to those who are willing to walk down the road he directs. Let me just be clear. That does not mean there are no dangers to be faced or hardships to overcome along the road if you walk the road with Jesus. Jesus told his disciples, in the world, you will have tribulation. But he also told them that through him, they were overcomers. Apostle Paul experienced more hardship and persecution during his ministry than most can imagine. Imprisonment, false accusation, hunger, shipwreck, and physical assault for preaching the gospel. But his relationship with God was so deep and trusting that he could write this. You could write this: none of these things move me. Do you have that kind of faith? Before I start, I want you to take a moment and ask yourself, where am I in my faith? Do I have Paul's faith? Do I have Peter's faith? Do I have the faith commended in the Bible? Or do I have the Pharisee's faith? Or the Canaanite's faith who worshipped Baal? Who am I putting my faith in today, in these days? In these end of days, Jesus or Baal? And if your faith isn't in Jesus alone, the truth, the way, and the life, I ask you to come to him today, because the end is very near. You don't have time. Another important thing I have learned, that once you walk that road with God and you follow God's instructions, temptations will show up, inviting you to take a detour and simply turn back. This is the plan of Satan. I call them spiritual attack, to discourage you from walking down God's road for your life. This attack will take various forms and will insert itself like a puzzle at different points along the road. It is critical that you recognize that that these experiences are not random, but instead are cleverly designed demonic plans, instead to stop you from moving forward. There are a lot, but I'm going to talk about 5 things the enemy uses to distract you from walking that road. The first one is the voices of other people that will discourage you from walking down God's road, calling you foolish, misguided, or unwise. When a person receives a call or direction from God for his or her life, the first obstacle that must be overcome is the pull of other people, including those the closest and most beloved. This happened to me. I remember when I came to faith, I came from a Catholic background, so I had to give up all religious beliefs to come to Jesus, all idols, saints, rosary, you name it. And the voice of other people calling me foolish, misguided, unwise was very harsh on me. I was following Jesus. It did affect my walk with God. In times I became very angry and fell into this trap many, many, many times. Sometimes I questioned God until I learned this is nothing but a strategy the enemy uses to disturb my peace with God. When you fall into this, shift your perspective and take it as a test of obedience to God. The second one is when you encounter difficulties and discomfort, which will cause you to question whether you took the right road or not. A false assumption among Christians is that once you have heard from God and have begun to walk down His road for your life, everything will fall into place and run smoothly. This thought pattern can lead to wonder if you miss God's will when circumstances become challenging. Many people are sidelined when they fall into a trap, mistakenly believing that they missed God's road just because the going got a little bit rough. Don't let this elementary tactic of the devil knock you off God's path for your life. Everyone on this earth faces adversity, but Romans 8:37 promises we are more than conquerors through Him who loved us. There is no circumstances in life that cannot be overcome by faith in the power of God. For every child of God defeats this evil world, and we achieve this victory through our faith. Apply your faith to your adversity and watch God overcome it. 3. Thoughts. Thoughts would attack your mind, suggesting you didn't hear and urging you to turn around before it's too late. When you are first learning to hear the voice of God, the devil works over time to inject doubt about whether you're truly hearing from God or just listening to your own thoughts. As you mature in this area of hearing God's voice, the enemy does not give up. Then when you take a step of faith and obedience to walk down the road of God's leading, Satan will increase the attack on your mind by insisting you are making a big mistake. He will accuse you of not hearing God, but following your own fleshly desires. Then he will push you to make a U-turn and go back before disaster occurs. Those are the times you must go back to the word of God spoken to you and hold fast to it regardless of the assault on your mind. The fourth one would be alternative roads will suddenly appear. One of my favorites. These roads will look easier and more attractive than the road you are on. Once you have embarked on God's road and have overcome the pressure of people's opinions, ignored difficulties along the road, and resisted the attack of doubts upon your mind, you must continue by faith, even when the road is long and the work is tough. It is at those moments an alluring temptation will be presented. This strategy will often appear when you are weary and struggling to keep going. The offer of an alternative route, a detour, which promises to get you the same place you are headed to, but by an easier road. But the detour is a trap, and it will not accomplish the will of God. I took lots of detours, and in my case, the enemy would put a preacher or another Christian blogger page in my way on Instagram that I become wanting to be them. What if God want me to do what she's doing? What if that's how I should talk? Maybe I should make a shorter video. Maybe I should talk about this subject. It is easier and less work, which led me to always wanting to become someone else. I take detours and detours, and I used to stop what I was doing, take a detour, and do what others are doing. As attractive and logical as this alternate route may appear, you must reject it. Walk down the road God has given you, and don't take any detours. 5. You will run into brick walls that appears immovable and will sorely tempt you to give up. When you have been faithfully following God's road and making some measures of progress, the enemy will increase pressure upon you to give up. Suddenly, roadblocks which look like immovable brick walls will block your way forward. The temptation to give up and turn back will be great. Those times will require you to press into the Lord for both His grace to carry on and His wisdom to know the next step. When it looks like there are no steps that can be taken, I have been praying to accomplish a specific task the Lord has given me. one brick wall after another has appeared as I have moved down this road of obedience to God. The only way I have continued to press on and not to give up has been by praying daily for grace and wisdom. And God has been faithful to answer those prayers and assist me each day. I have counted on the following scriptures, promises, and I encourage you to do the same. First verse was from Hebrews 4:16. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. If you need wisdom, ask our generous God, and He will give it to you. He will not rebuke you for asking. James 1:5. Once you have heard from God, don't let anything discourage you from remaining on His road. This is where it will bring forth fruit in your life that has no comparison with the earthly path you could choose to follow. These were the five things that Satan uses, that the enemy uses to disturb us from our walking with God. I pray that this video was a blessing for you. Like it, share it with a friend, just so we recognize the enemy's tactic in our life and the enemy's things that could attack us through to disturb that relationship with God. Until next time, I want you to know that God loves you. Let's do life with Him.